Hey guys, it's Abby from theontherocks.com, but instead of filming for my main site, I'm actually going to film for my food blog, so here it is. Today I wanted to talk about a couple goals that I listed on my food blog a while back, and it was before the end of the year. I wanted to buy at least 3 cookbooks, and part of that goal was also to cook a dish from each cookbook. Now, I'm yet to buy a cookbook, which is sad, and for many reasons. One, I find it pointless for me to buy a cookbook. I just cannot grasp the idea of spending money on a cookbook that I'm not really going to look at. Second of all, I don't feel like I can find a cookbook that's going to have all the dishes that I want to make or I'm interested in making. Third is I don't find it necessary for me to pay like $20 to $30 per cookbook that I'm not really going to enjoy. Now, I know there are other good cookbooks out there, and I know I can go to either half.com, eBay, Amazon, and I know I'll find good deals. But like I said, I just can't really buy myself or push myself to buy a cookbook. Not yet. So instead of buying a cookbook, I have decided to go ahead and do a little research and put one together. So here's my cookbook. It's actually organized the way that I want it to. What I did was I went online and researched on different sites, and I pretty much printed it out. And I know you're probably thinking, like, it's expensive to buy all that stuff. Actually, it was provided to me for free, so I was able to put together a bunch of stuff. Now, this isn't actually the only binder that I have. I actually have a couple more that I'm working on. This one doesn't even have like, the paper pages yet. The big one that I showed you, that's like the main cookbook. So I'm just showing you guys what it looks like. That's the sample. Oh, by the way, I decided to put this all together when I had to figure out how to cook for someone who's vegan. So you guys know my boyfriend's vegan, and I actually consider myself a pretty well cook. A home cook, and I don't really have a problem with finding whatever ingredients is available and making a dish out of it. Unfortunately, my boyfriend's vegan, strictly vegan, so I had to learn how to cook for a vegan rather than just steaming vegetables, right? Because there's more dishes than that a vegan person can eat. But yeah, I did my research, so this whole thing's pretty much about vegan cooking. Oh, and which I, by the way, love too. I guess you could say most of the time I do eat vegan now, and that's not because of my boyfriend. Well, part of it is because of my boyfriend, but part of it is also because I actually like vegan food. I noticed that I really, really, really enjoy vegan food, and I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm also allergic to dairy products and poultry, seafood. I don't really eat red meat. I don't eat pork. Just because bad experience, I guess you could say. So for the most part, everything that I could be eating, I'm pretty much gonna die from. So, oh, and also, there's also a lot of things I'm also allergic to, but that'll be on a different video or post. But yeah, you know, I guess if you're a stay-at-home mom and you're the type who likes to cook, I would suggest just trying to find the recipe that works for you, print it out, and save it, because honestly, there's no point of, for me, there's no point of buying a cookbook if you're not gonna like fully read the whole thing. Now, if you're just looking back on things that you've already made and you know that it's something that you're gonna eat all over again and you just wanna remember the exact recipes or, you know, end up mastering it or making it into your own, I suggest just printing out that page of recipes that you want. I don't know if I said that right. Also, the other cookbook too, I also did this for baking. So there's the cookies, I don't know if you guys can see that, it's on cookies. This is also all on vegan baking. So this is like for white chocolate ganache, but it's all vegan. So it's pretty interesting. So yeah, I figure that I didn't really need a lot of regular, ordinary recipes because I already know how to cook for someone who is a vegan. And so I did my research on vegan cooking and vegan baking, and pretty much what I came up with. And I pretty much just sat there whenever I was free, had free time, and printed everything out, just went through the recipes, thought it was interesting, and I actually have tried a couple dishes myself. But I'm gonna go ahead and post those up for you guys to try yourself too. So I guess that's pretty much it. That's all I really wanted to share with you guys. I know it's kind of different and kind of new, but since I'm trying something different, yeah, definitely. If you guys end up doing this, or if you guys have any ideas about how to properly keep or organize your recipes, hit me up. Let me know what you guys think about it. So yeah. Bye.